Yo, it is entirely way too early for life right now, but we're here. Anaheim, Sneakercon, California. And this is probably gonna be the last time you see my shoes this clean. But your boy's in J's, man. Your boy's wearing J's. And we're walking in through the front because the hotel that we're staying at is actually connected to the convention center. And I wanted you guys to check out this line a little bit.
Some too, I'm hungry.
I gotta see my guy when SneakerCon, I'm gonna get a case, I'm gonna buy a case off,
No.
The day before yesterday.
What is it, a 10?
This is the second one I passed. Is this the only one that you got?
No, I got a few of them, but I mean, once I finish setting up, I'll show you what I got.
Cool. I'm so hungry. I have not had a Monster. I have not had a Slim Jim. Why you look so lost, bro?
I can't fucking find my table, bro.
Big A Customs. BIGACUSTOM. Big A Customs.
This guy right here, like one of the ugliest people I've known
for a long time.
Like he's one in the sneaker game. Like I met this dude, I couldn't have been selling shoes for more than 3 weeks.
Back.
How long did we stand in that line?
2 days.
All right, 2 days. See, he's already fucking up the story. And now it's not even gonna sound believable, but anyway.
Yeah, LeBron Corks.
LeBron
Corks. I was top eight.
Yeah.
I had eight people with me.
And I was there before you.
Yeah.
And I got D-Bowed off of shit. I stood in line for 4 days.
It was 4 days, right. And I did land on.
And I slept 2 hours the day before, the day of the
You had on them butter ass Barclays. Them All-Star Barclays.
And Area 72.
Yeah. That was a good time, man. MYQUISTADOR.
at least there's AC here. It ain't like over there where it's hot as hell right now. What's going on, guys? Like, I think it's awesome to see that as sneakerheads, we get the opportunity over a course of a weekend to hang out with a whole bunch of people that understand what we're doing and why we're into this stuff. We're about to get it. Already doing buybacks consignment. I think we're almost 30 bands in. In 3 hours, we got here late in the morning. So we're spending about an hour.
$1,000 an hour.
I'll see y'all soon, man. New video coming up soon. Adios.
Sean Flores, inspired by Joshua Vince. Peace out. discussion for you guys. If you are a reseller of any sorts, if you brought one shoe to sell here, if you brought 30 shoes to sell here, this is the panel discussion for you. So first off, we got my man JC, 2J's Kicks from Urban Necessities. And these guys, you probably won't know too much because they're behind the scenes on the grind, but we got Scotty from Soul Supremacy and Sam from Soul Stage. So we're here today to talk about how to be a reseller. So we'll start off with JC, because he likes to rant a little bit, so I'll just cut him off. Let's start off, Jay. How did you get it? What was the first shoe you sold, period?
Pink foam posits.
The pink foam posits. Those came out in Black Friday weekend of 2012.
So for me, it was 2012,
6 years ago. It was November 6 years ago. Pink foams. But that shoe, what got you to buy it and want to sell it?
One of the managers at Foot Locker sucked me into it, said there was crazy resale, but I made $7 off that.
How did you go from being release to release reseller to like, okay, now I'm ready to open up a shop and do this to this level?
You know, to be honest, I don't think I was ready when I opened. I was reselling shoes, doing pre-orders like pretty much everybody does. And what was happening with me was I started getting 86th out of stores in Vegas because I was buying too many shoes, or like other customers were upset with the fact that management was sliding pairs to me at a much larger rate than most. And I didn't really have a way to move around. So I switched it to everybody I had ever sold the shoe to. I'm like, hey man, you guys complain about the cost of the next one every single time, but you don't wear any of the stuff that I'm selling you. Why don't you let me sell that? It's all gained value. And we did a really small sneaker show, and I went from like 13 pairs 2 weeks before that event to like 700 pairs right up into that event. And I was like, damn, if I could get all these shoes on Spit Handshakes, imagine if we had a store. And that's kind of how UN came about.
But tell me a little bit about that change in technology, no more lineups. How did that affect your business? We'll start on your end from here.
How did it affect it? I think it affected it a little bit of in a positive way, though, unfortunately. And fortunately, it put the market in a certain individual's hands. Kids who were running the bots were able to get mass quantity and kind of dictate the market. So on the bot end, but now that's kind of done with. Nike has kind of killed that off, and so has everybody else. But I think the biggest change in the marketplace has been the apps. StockX and GOAT has changed the marketplace 100% now.
And now Sneakercon launched yesterday. Which you guys should here.
You guys should download that app, by the way.
Yeah, Sneakercon app is live on the App Store. Now for the consignment side, things are a little different. It's a little different business. So how did that, you know, were your sellers having a harder time with the shift? Were they able to still get pairs when they all went digital?
For my higher tier consigners, the guys that are really moving units, all the changes that have happened are for the betterment of the business side of it, right? It's made them much more efficient. It's forcing people to evolve and not stay stuck, right? Like 3-4 years ago, 5 years ago, it wasn't really realistically to consistently get 20, 100, 500 pairs of something as it is now, right? These businesses, and because of all the changes that have happened in the culture and all these extra added avenues, is forcing retailers to do what was blasphemous a couple years ago. Now it's part of it. So it's cleaned it up. You're not seeing as many fights at some of the, you know, like releases. You're not seeing these long lines that are hurting the community or whatever, making a mess. So, and now the consumer is a much smarter consumer too, because they understand time and effort, and they know they can go through respected avenues to get it. So I think the whole culture has been improved by it. The guy that's stuck in his ways, that says, thinks it's 88, 89, it's not for you no more. You know what I mean? And I got guys that got on the train with us early and bought into, hey, we have to offer the lowest consignment rate and we have to put our prices lower than everyone else and we'll move value as opposed to margin. But that's the new way of thinking. Like thinking you're gonna hit home runs all day long doesn't exist anymore in our culture.
So day one, recap. We spent over $150,000 and the show's still going on, but we're taking stuff to FedEx to ship out and we're gonna do it all over again tomorrow. We still got shirts, we still got pop sockets, and I'm still gonna be right here trying to buy some shoes from Hughes. Adios.